Hello, and welcome. Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X, for a quick tutorial on cargo, or on how we can make a cargo box show us when it's full. We've all been there, and on the PC we have access to innumerable scripts and things, but on the console, on the Xbox, we don't have access to those. All we've got is the event controller. So, just let me construct a little self-powered platform here. So we can play around with this and I can show you how to set up a very simple system that lets us use an event controller to monitor the contents of a cargo box. So first of all, we're going to need a cargo box, and that's the all way around, so let's just do that. So one cargo box later, and since we're not using multiple cargo boxes, we don't need to worry about naming it and so on. But if you get into the habit of naming things, you'll get on a lot better with the game. So first of all, we're going to set up a way to monitor when this is full. And a really good way to do that is to find the LCD panels in comms and hangars. And you want the corner. No. You want the flat top. Like so. Then the arrows are facing up. It's all well and good. So that's online. Look directly at it, tap both bumpers, as it says, and press the two squares, and you'll open up its menu. And we want to come all the way down here until we reach content and change it to text and images. And then we just want to edit that text and we'll just say full. Now, that's a bit small. So we're going to put it at full size. And then we're going to align it to the center. And before we come out of that, just press X and turn off that screen. Now we're going to set up our event controller. But first of all, we're just going to change the time of day a little by holding down RB and Y, opening up the admin screen, going to admin tools and choosing time of day. Just a little. There. So we want our event controller. You'll find that in advanced systems. And then we just go through, pushing up on the D-pad until we reach our event controller. There it is. Okay, we're almost sorted. Go into your event controller through the control panel there, and we want to set it up to look for cargo filled equal or greater than 100. However, what we don't want to do is we don't want to use both bumpers, or we do want to use both bumpers to push it to the middle and then push it further to the right. However, if we do that, I'll show you what happens. So we'll leave it like that for the time being. So we're at 100%. We could have typed 100 in to the actual thing, or just pushed the slider until it was at 100. But we want, or I want to demonstrate what happens if you use both bumpers to do this. So we're going to add our small cargo box to the monitoring of these blocks. And then we're going to choose select actions. And from this menu, we're going to jump to the corner LCD flat top. And we're going to say, if this statement is true, we're going to toggle the block on. Toggle. And then if it's false, turn it off. Now, if this equals 100%, our block should turn on. And if it doesn't, our block should be off. So, what will happen though, because I used both bumpers and right on the D-pad, in theory, nothing should happen. I'll show you how to correct that, but first of all, we're going to need to put some cargo into our cargo container. What we can do here is press in the right stick until we get to the menu, and you'll see open spawn menu. We're going to pick a salt cannon shell. We're going to choose the amount. I've already pre-done this, but just hit all the nines and choose spawn object. We'll pick all that up because we're playing in creative. It shouldn't be a problem. Then if we open up our cargo box by pressing X and then use our D-pad to put those shells into the small cargo container, you'll notice nothing happens. This is because what's actually happened is with the right bumper, our cargo equal or greater than is actually reading at more than 100%. It can't do it. So if you hold down the left bumper, and tap it, you'll see eventually it will change. So 99.9, 100. If you push it to the right again with the left bumper held, it will action slot 2, which is turn off the block. So we want it to turn on the block when it's full. So if we push once, it's still 100%, but it's now actually reading at 100%. Not 99.9, but 100. And you'll see that it's showing that our cargo box is full. So we just pull all those out. That's offline. So when this box fills up, like so, our light or our sign comes on and the box is indicating that it's full. And this will work with any box that you add to the list. So if we add another cargo container, like so, we can go into here, go down, and you know we're now going to small cargo container 2. We'll add that to the list to monitor. And to fix this, what we want to do here is we want to change the way the system works. Because if you remember, event controllers can control more than one thing. So with this system, you can control, give me a second, are we using the right one? Yes, we are. And press X. Go into the menu, text and images. Center, and there we are. So now, hold on, we need to turn that one off, because at the moment it can monitor this box, but it cannot tell this box what to do. So let's just pull those out. So what we want to do is come back into our event controller, back to our select actions, and this time we're going to use the second toolbar by tapping RT when we're down at the toolbar select itself, and we want corner LCD flat top 2 on, off. Shouldn't have to set anything else up. Full. And full. And so this way, you can set up multiple things to trigger. And multiple blocks. In fact, you can set on one event controller 9 of these, so that you could monitor 9 cargo boxes off one event controller. And there you go. That is how to make a very simple system without scripting, because we have no access to scripts on console. Apart from if we play on a dedicated server, and then we only have access to those scripts which will run server-side, not client-side. Now, ICE's inventory management script, I do believe, runs on server-side scripting, so you could use that. But for solo and hosted multiplayer, this is the way to go to let you know that your boxes are full. You can't monitor what's in them and display it. We don't have the functionality for that, and we just can't, unless Keen builds that script into the vanilla game for us and bakes it in directly. And there you have it. That's my tutorial on cargo box indicators, or whatever you want to call it. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks for the likes, the subscribes, the support. It means a lot. And I definitely will catch you in the next one. Bye for now.